Today, let us study the shear force and bending moment diagram. Now, we will do it for cantilever beam with a UDL, that is uniformly distributed load. Now, here is a beam with a cantilever in which a uniformly distributed load is applied. This can be in the terms of unit per unit run, or it can be W Newton per meter. The length of the cantilever beam is small l, or we can say the span of the cantilever beam is small l. Now let us cut a section at a small distance of x. This is the section. Now total load applied on this cantilever beam will be small w into l. This is a small w load multiplied by its length L. Bending moment. Bending moment we will find out at this section Mx. At this section Mx, bending moment will be load multiplied by the distance, multiplied by the CG or half of the distance. So it will be minus W into X into X by 2. So it will be Wx square by 2. This minus Wx square by 2 is for this section xx. Now if we want to find out the bending moment at point B, this mb, here x, the value of x is 0, so the bending moment will be 0. So it is this, here we will put 0, so it is 0. Now at A, our length of x is L. So we will put value of x is equal to L. Here in this equation, we will get the value of moment MA, that is minus WL square by 2. So minus WL square by 2 is a parabolic equation. So the bending moment diagram drawn for this cantilever beam with UDL will be this parabola. The curve is parabola, and this is minus WL square by 2. This is the bending moment generated due to the application of this W per unit run load. Now let us move to the shear force for this cantilever beam will be SFXX, that is the shear force at this section XX. The shear force at this section xx will be the load multiplied by the span. Our span at this xx section is small x. So it will be minus w into x. Now, shear force at B, here. At B, the value of x is 0. So our shear force is 0. It will be SFB is equal to 0. Now, shear force at point A. Shear force at point A will be minus W into L. Here the value of X is equal to L. So it will be minus W into L. See that it is 0 here. It is WX here. It is WL here. So this SFD will be formed for this cantilever beam in the pattern of triangle. Let us solve a problem for this. Here we have a problem, solve following problem for cantilever beam. The beam is as shown below. Here we have cantilever beam, this is the beam. At 1 meter distance, 3 kN load is applied. Then from 1.5 meter distance, this is 1.5. UDL for a span of 2 meter is applied, whose amount is 1 kN per meter. Now at a 0.5 meter distance, 2.5 kN load is applied. This is our problem which we have to solve for cantilever beam. First we will calculate the reaction in this. Now calculate support reaction. How we are going to calculate the support reaction? We will put, this is the reaction which will occur at the fixed support. We have named it as A, so the reaction will be RA. RA will be equal to the load vertically applied. This is moving upward. The upward load will be considered as positive and the downward load will be considered as negative. So it is RA is equal to 3 kilonewton plus 1 into 2 UDL plus 2.5 kilonewton load. So the reaction RA is equal to 7.5 kilonewton. Now let us calculate the bending moment. Bending moment at point A here at fixed support. The bending moment at this point A will be this 2.5 kilonewton load multiplied by the span, which is 5 meter. Then for this UDL, it is 1 kilonewton into its span, which is 2 meter, 1 into 2, multiplied by this much distance, that is 1 plus 1.5, which is 2.5, plus half of this distance, which is 2, plus 2 by 2. And for this 3 kilonewton load, it will be 3 into 1. So our total bending moment obtained is minus 22.5 kilonewton meter. The moment generated due to this load will try to move the beam in clockwise direction, but the reaction moment which will be generated will be of opposite nature, so it will be minus 22.5 kilonewton meter. Now we can find out this bending moment at all the points. At E, here our bending moment will be 0. At point D, here our bending moment will be 2.5 multiplied by its span, which is 0.5, so it will be minus 1.25 kilonewton meter. At point C, here it will be minus 2.5 multiplied by this distance into 2.5 plus 1 into 2 into half of the distance, it is 2 by 2. So it will be minus 8.25 kilonewton. Now let us calculate it at point B. At point B, it will be 2.5 multiplied by this span, which is 4. Then for UDL, it will be 1 into 2. This is 1 into 2. Multiplied by span, which is 1.5 plus 2 by 2. 1.5 plus 2 by 2. So it will be 1. It will be minus 15 kilonewton meter. This will be the bending moment obtained for these loads. So the bending moment diagram will be drawn like this. Bending moment diagram will be drawn like this. It is 0 at point E. At D, it is 1.25, which will be a straight line. Then here it will be a curvy linear line which will take the shape of parabolas because the load is UDL. Again there will be a straight line for point load, and again the straight line for this load, that is 22.5 kilonewton. So this will be our bending moment diagram. Now let us move to the shear force diagram. Shear force for this will be, we will start it from point E. Shear force at E, it will be minus 2.5 kilonewton, this load, minus 2.5 kilonewton. Then at point C, here our load will be 2.5 plus 1 into 2, it will be minus 4.5 kilonewton. At point B, it will be 2.5 plus 1 into 2 plus 3, it will be 7.5 kilonewton. At point A, it will be 3 plus 1 into 2 plus 2.5, it will be 7.5 kilonewton. At point D, it will be minus 2.5 kilonewton. Now we have all the value of shear force at all the points. By taking this value, we will draw the shear force diagram. Here is our shear force diagram. The value at E, it is 2.5, so it will be 2.5. and it will remain same at point D. Now at point C it is 4.5. So at point C it is 4.5. It will be a straight line, but it will be inclined. Then at point B it is 4.5 kilonewton. So it is 7.5 kilonewton here. 7.5 kilonewton. So up to this point it is 4.5. Then the remaining 3 kilonewton distance will be drawn. So now it will be total 7.5 kilonewton. It is 7.5 kilonewton. At point A it is 7.5 kilonewton. So this is the derivation for this problem of cantilever beam. Thank you.